We can compute the logarithm of a diagonalizable matrix, but what about the logarithm of a scaling rotation matrix, or of a matrix similar to a scaling rotation matrix? Can we compute that logarithm too? Well, yes we can, using the same trick as you will learn in this video. So we want to compute the log of A, and now A is similar to C. So we know A equals BCP inverse, C has some special properties, and B is the log of A. Again, we want to solve e to the power of b equals a, and the easiest way to do that is to find some a tilde, such that a tilde, e to the power a tilde equals a. And you do this by looking at how a looks, of course, and that gives you some clues how to find your a tilde. So, what do we do? We say, well, our a tilde equals some p tilde c tilde p inverse tilde. You know, from the lemma that we can take the p's and the p inverses out. So this already looks quite a lot like a, because a equals pcp inverse. So now we want to find p tilde and c tilde such that a is equal to e to the power a tilde equals this matrix, this one. So a has to be equal to p tilde e to the power c tilde p tilde inverse. But we know a equals pcp inverse. So what do you do? First of all, you pick p tilde equals p, that part is okay. And then you want to find your some c tilde, such that e to the power c tilde equals c. And now the nice part of scaling rotation matrices is that if you put them in an exponent, they kind of remain scaling rotation matrices. So this c tilde will be also some scaling rotation matrix, but another one, and c. So how do we find our c tilde then? That's the next step. So first you write your C matrix in polar form. So the one you have your A equals PCP inverse, so you have your C, and you write that one in polar form like this. So you find the R and the theta. And then you notice that your C tilde will be some other scaling rotation matrix. So you do not write this one in polar form, you write this one in normal form with an A, B, and minus B like this. Well, why is that? If you now compute the exponent of your c tilde, so e to the power of c tilde, so what do you get? You use this Euler type of formula, you get e to the power a, and with the b's you set in the cosine and in the sines. So that's how you compute e to the power c tilde. And then you compare. You want your e to the power c tilde to be equal to c, and you see the matrices have the same structure. So that works if you make this amplitudes the same, so you have to pick e to the power a equals r, and you know your r. And you see that your cosine of theta has to be the same as the cosine of b, the sine of theta has to be the same as the sine of b. So you have those two conditions over here. Now, we solve those equations. The first one is trivial. You have a has to be the ln of r. And for the second one, cosine theta equals cosine b, and sine theta equals sine b, so that b can be equal to theta, but you can add multiples of 2 pi, where k is in z. So you see, actually, you have many solutions, infinitely many solutions for this problem. So your c tilde, here you put your a, your ln of r, and here you put your minus theta plus k times 2 pi. So, and you can pick any k you like, and that leads to e to the power c tilde equals your c. And then combine everything. Well, you know, A equals PCP inverse. Your C equals e to the power C tilde. You just found your C tilde. So you replace the C over here. And due to the lemma, you could take the P's and P inverses inside the exponent. And then you are over here. Here we have the explicit expression for your C tilde that we found in the step 5 over there. Now you compare exponents. You wanted to solve e to the power b equals a, which is now written in the form of e to the power of something. So comparing exponents, you see that can be equal to that matrix. So actually, you see if you now compute the log of a scaling rotation matrix, you do not have one log, but you have many logs, infinitely many. And if you have done complex analysis, this feature of a log may remind you of the logarithm of complex numbers, which show a similar property.